The Honourable Member for Dartmouth South.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I'd like to, first of all, welcome back all of the members of this legislature back to the House. It's great to see everybody back. Yourself, Mr. Speaker, all of my colleagues here on the Liberal side. I've got to be honest, it's probably the first time I've ever had anyone suggest that they actually grew up wanting to be me. So that was a pleasure to hear, and I appreciated that. And I'm not really sure why that the member for Halifax Atlantic would want to be me, other than perhaps my hair. But we all would like to be other people, and at times I would like to be the member for Halifax Atlantic as well. I mean, he's got some ink. I've got some ink, but he's got a lot more than I do. So there's lots there. But I do want to welcome everyone back. It's been a great summer. We've all been hard at work, and there's been lots of things we've all been doing that I do want to address in just a couple of short moments. But I also want to take a moment to welcome back a couple of the members in particular, as the previous speaker, of course, the Honourable Member for Argyll-Barrington, was just referencing. Two of our colleagues in particular, the member for Sydney River, Myra Lewisburg, and of course the member for Sydney Whitney Pier. And as he mentioned, their marvelous and great struggles with their health, and I think it's a great testament, certainly, to their desire to serve their constituents, their desire to work in this legislature, that they were here for the events yesterday and are going to be here as often as they can. I think that's a marvelous testament to them. I would like to take a moment. I personally was not in the legislature yesterday, and I appreciate the indulgence of the speaker in excusing me from the proceedings yesterday. I was not, because I was actually over at the Nova Scotia Cancer Clinic myself with my wife, and I just wanted to take a moment to give a little shout out to certainly the members opposite who are struggling with their health, and to my wife Yvonne, who is now refacing cancer after surviving breast cancer 3 years ago and going through her partial mastectomy and radiation treatments. The cancer has returned, and she's now undergoing chemotherapy and will go through a session of chemotherapy and so on. So I spent the day yesterday with her second chemotherapy session. And I sat there for quite a bit of time thinking about what was happening in the House and where our priorities are and where things are important to us. And there's no doubt that family and health and well-being are the priorities for all of us. I can tell you this, that cancer clinic was full for the entire day, full of individuals, young people, old people, workers, retired people. These are people that didn't want to be there. These are people that didn't have a choice to be there. But they are there, and they're each fighting their independent battles. Mr. Speaker, I know you've had your challenges in your life, and you've risen, and you've fought them, and success that you've shown all of us here today. The members opposite as well, who are fighting their battles, continue to do so. Cancer and disease, issues of health, they don't wear any political colors. They're not Liberals or NDPs or Progressive Conservatives. They take all of us. They take all of us far too soon. But the other thing that I was realizing as I was sitting there, and I've had this discussion with my wife, we've had lots of discussions over the past several weeks since the return of her diagnosis and the prognosis and so on, and I'm a firm believer, and always have been, in the power of positive thinking, the power of looking for the positive, be it in your health, be it in your lifestyle, be it in everything that we do. All too often, there's opportunities for negativity in this legislature. It's easy to find and pick on the things that we think are going wrong or things that we think we're doing wrong without really focusing at all on the positive things that we are all doing in this legislature. So I do want to take a few moments and spend some time looking at just some of the positive things that we have done as a legislature, that we have done as a government, that we intend to do going forward. I started on the topic of health care, so it's probably fitting that we continue on with health care. And it's one of the reasons that I am so proud to be part of this government, to sit with these caucus members. It's why I'm so proud to be in this legislature with the members opposite as well and with yourself, Mr. Speaker. It is because we are all working to find the best solution. Like the cancer team, and I use that word specifically, team, that is working with my wife that I know is working with each of the respective colleagues opposite that are facing their struggles, but particularly those facing the cancer struggles. It's a team of individuals. Each has their specific strengths and their specific weaknesses. That's exactly what happens in this legislature. It's exactly what happens in this caucus. We have strengths, we have weaknesses. We take the opportunity, though, to listen to each other and to work together on all sides of this House to try and do better for the people of Nova Scotia, the people who don't deserve to be in that cancer ward, the people who don't necessarily need or deserve to be in institutions for children, the people who don't deserve to be in institutions for mental disabilities or physical disabilities, the people who don't deserve to be looking for employment assistance and income assistance at every opportunity because they just can't find the job. It is our responsibility on all sides to continue to move forward and do what we can to try and stop all of that at every opportunity. Let me take a moment or two to look at some of the things we have done with regards to health. My riding of Dartmouth South, of course, is home to the Dartmouth General Hospital. From the day I was elected, I started having meetings with the chief of staff over there, Dr. Todd Howlett. Took me on a great tour of the facility, showed me what wonderful work is done in that facility each and every day, but also showed me some of the changes that we are needed, some of the things that we have to do to move forward, things that were started by previous administrations and for whatever reason didn't necessarily get moved along as quickly as they might have. I took those discussions, I went and I spoke with our Minister of Health. Had some great discussions with him, some discussions with the Premier, some discussions with health staff. What can we do? What can we do to move things forward? Our Minister of Health was one of the first ones to say, I'm looking at the Dartmouth General. I know what we need to do over there. We need to improve our health facilities right across this province, whether it's from Yarmouth to Sydney, from Amherst down to the HRM. But Dartmouth generally said certainly needs our attention. And one of the things right away, of course, we heard, and I was so pleased to have the announcement made there on the grounds of the Dartmouth General with the Minister and many others from caucus as well, was the infusion of $5.2 million in funding for healthcare restructuring in this province. That's healthcare restructuring and renovations that are going to be happening at the QE2 here in Halifax and as well at the Dartmouth General. It's renovations to the third and fourth floor because, once again, there are far too many Nova Scotians, regardless of their political stripe, regardless of what they think about unions or non-unions or employment income, who are simply struggling to stay alive because their health is an issue. We need to improve our health at every opportunity, and we need to improve our health institutions. And it's no question, and it's obvious why we spend so much money on health care each and every year. It's the biggest part of our budget. But that's where it deserves to be, because the health of our citizens should be paramount among everything else in this society. Part of the money will also be going towards working to develop and design the new operating units at the Dartmouth General. There's talk of 8 floors at the Dartmouth General for an operating series of operating theaters, and we look forward to announcements such as that later down the road. We have established a new physician retrainment and recruitment program. The idea, of course, to keep more doctors in this province. The last thing that should ever happen to any Nova Scotian is that they have a problem with their health or the health of their family, and they can't find a family physician to go to. So our government recognized that need and immediately said, we've got to do what we can, and immediately said, let's put in place a program to retain physicians and keep them in this province so they can serve our constituents. We acted on our commitment right away to reduce wait times for health issues that aren't necessarily as critical or life and death, if you will, as cancer or some of the other illnesses, but are certainly just as critical to getting our people back into the workforce as quickly as possible, to getting them back to living fulfilling lives as quickly as possible with the need for orthopedic surgeries. So we invested $4.2 million to try and decrease the wait times in our healthcare facilities. I want to remember several, there's all sorts of people. I mean, I've spent the summer, as all of us have, going around my constituency, meeting individuals every day, individuals who come into my constituency office. My very good friend, my colleague from Halifax Atlantic, said it so well, and I have no intention of going anywhere near trying to upstage him, on saying the importance of what we do doesn't happen in this house. The importance of what we do happens each and every day. You're absolutely correct, sir. And that's what has been most fulfilling for me. It's been most frustrating for me too, quite frankly, on a daily basis, are those days when people and individuals come in and I know I want to help them, I try to find the ways to help them, but for whatever reasons, the system isn't there to do it, or I just can't find the funding, or we just can't find a quick and easy solution. Those are frustrating days, but we continue to work with them and to try and find ways of helping them. Admittedly, those days are balanced with the good days, when someone comes in and has a problem, or needs some assistance, or needs some help trying to find a housing, or needs some help with health care, and we're able to direct them in the right place. We're able to get them that help and move it forward. That's the job of each and every one of us. That's why we were elected. There's a lot of parrying and thrusting that goes on within these chambers here. That's the spirit of debate. It's the spirit of the democracy of the government that we all represent and that we all recognize is important to our future going forward. It's why our forefathers fought and died to allow us to be able to do that. And that's why it is important. But really what it comes down to is it's what happens in those constituency offices, working to help the people that we need to work as hard as possible for them. Over the past 9 months or so, our government has been making all sorts of announcements in all sorts of areas that are helping people. They're working to try and improve the situation in this province. Like the cancer diagnosis, is there an easy answer? Absolutely not. There probably isn't an answer. There are best alternatives. We best the odds. We roll the dice and say, based on statistics, this is what we think will work the best. And we hold on to that hope. We have to hold on to that hope, because in those life and death situations, it's really the only hope we have. So we also have to look at the best options. People will differ. That's what it's all about. The medical team differs. The medical oncologist says, let's try these drugs. The surgical oncologist says, no, you know what, maybe we can go in and do surgery. The radiation oncologist says, yeah, no, perhaps there's radiation. But in the end, everyone gets together. They take their differences of opinion. They take their different views, and they collectively move forward. And that's what we have to do on all of these issues. So I'm going to just, I have quite a few, and I am looking at the clock, Mr. Speaker. I do know in the interest of time, I will just touch on seniors at this point, and then perhaps we'll see how the time is going at that. Seniors, of course, in Dartmouth South is a large part of our riding. We have a huge area around Baker Drive in particular, new developments with seniors complexes that are going up all the time. Lots of seniors come into my office on a regular basis looking for help, looking for assistance. They're struggling. Their bills are increasing, their power bills are increasing, and yet their incomes remain steady. They have health issues. They are the ones that are perhaps most vulnerable to health issues as well, on top of all the economic issues they may already be facing. They want to stay in their homes. They realize the value of staying in their homes as long as possible, but in some instances, they just can't do that any longer. This government and this caucus immediately recognize some of those challenges. Started talking about those challenges from day one. What are we going to do to help the seniors to avoid some of these things? And just a couple of the things that we know. $9 million announced by our minister so far for housing improvements, for renovations and benefits for seniors. $4 million of that was announced in the spring, $5 million just this past fall. One of the buildings in particular that was one of the very first issues that came to my office when I was elected, Alderney Manor. People in Alderney Manor that are struggling with their daily lives, that are struggling to make ends meet, and really just want to go home to a comfortable home that they can call home and they can enjoy as their home. People like Shirley and Art and Gwen and Susan. People that I've come to know very, very well, who every day struggle with some of the challenges of bed bugs, some of the challenges with issues in their heating, conditions that really aren't suitable for our seniors and those with some disabilities in particular at all. So our Minister of Community Services, I spoke to her, one of the very first discussions I had as an MLA for Dartmouth South was to go and meet with the Minister of Community Services and say, what are we going to do about Alderney Manor? What are we going to do about all of those citizens in that building that need our help? And she said, Alan, we are going to work as quickly as possible to make the changes that we have to make in that building. And that announcement that I've just referred to goes directly to the people of Alderney Manor and to that building, changing the parking facilities in that building, attacking the bed bug problem by infusing a chemical or a substance into the walls that's going to hopefully really permanently deal with this bed bug issue that's been prevalent in that building for so long. Also working to improve the facilities in the building at every opportunity. Mr. Speaker, I do have an awful lot more that I want to go through, and I am looking at the clock, and I would actually move that in the interest of time at this point in the day, and given that I do have a little bit longer, I'd like to talk, perhaps we would adjourn the debate for today, if that's possible, sir.